Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to Morals and Minutes. I am Muhammad Ali, and today we will talk about the danger of grudges. When the reader dives into the traditions of the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, and his family, that is found in our books, he will discover many teachings that encompass and span a variety of categories. Furthermore, at times you find a sentence composed of less than five or four words, yet the sentence can be allowed to be applied to every human being. The words can save us from our daily problems and keep our relations with the family and friends always concrete and unbreakable. Let us look at a tradition from the Holy Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, and his family, in which we can take from its wonders. It is narrated that he said, "Do not hold grudges." How many words in this golden tradition? Four words from which we can extract teachings and we can take as a lesson in our daily lives. Grudges are dangerous, and holding on to them leads only to more destruction and pain. It has been proven by medical researchers in the West who study the human physique and body that grudges can be harmful and lead to negative effects on the body. In an article by WebMD dated February 25, 2005, it says, "When people think about their offenders in unforgiving ways, they tend to experience stronger negative emotions and greater physical stress responses. In contrast, when these same people think about their offenders in more forgiving ways, they tend to experience great positive emotions and greater perceived control and less potent negative emotions and stress in the short term." This article dates about 10 years back, and today there is even more researchers in this regard. We can say that this discovery is at least decades or century old, but when we look at the low placed fort by the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, and his family, which dates back 1400 years ago, we can come to the same golden conclusion. He informed us not to carry grudges and to be forgiving to thy friend and enemy. He is an example, since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, "An excellent example for those who hope in Allah and the last day." Let us hold on to these traditions and not hold grudges, but be forgiving, so we can emulate the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, and his family in our communities, and show the world the meaning behind, "We have not sent you, but as a mercy to all worlds." Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you.